Hello everybody, this is Real Time again here, and welcome back to another reaction videos. And today we're going to be reacting to the S-Fan FNAF The Hidden Lord 2. And as usual, we're going to be reacting to episode 3 and 4, you know, 2 episodes in 1 videos by Zapper770, obviously. And again, I was really hyped to see what's actually going to happen next, obviously. And hopefully we get to see Mike Smith again, like, you know, Mike Smith's story. And then I know we got Peter and Springtrap's story, but I kind of want to see Mike Smith first, you know, because, I don't know, I just feel like he was more interesting, at least for me, but at the same time, I'm also curious about Peter's story, so without further ado, let's get into the video, shall we? Also, yeah, I get a haircut, so so I'm bald right now. Anyway, Zapper 770 production.
Oh, oh shit. No, 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 no. I can't die, man. Like this. Damn it. Why does it have to be me? Who is locked down in the basement? Oh, it's Mike. Who is the boy that got ran over by the bus? Mike. Oh, how about the boy that life maltreats in every single turn? I wonder. Oh, what a surprise. It's me again! It's always fucking me! It was never Jeremy. It was never Chuck. It was always me! So if you want to stuff me, then fucking do it already, because you'll be doing me a huge favor!
Jeremy and Chuck? I think I remember seeing that name, or mentioning that name. Is he related to the 5 missing kids? Oh, it's Freddy.
Mike Smith.
Huh.
How do you know my name?
Of course I know your name. We all remember you.
What?
We remember you, Mike. 1984.
Oh, shit. Oh, so all of them is actually
you and
Mike's
me
friend.
Were at Freddy's at the time with our parents. When a man came by and asked us if he wanted to play a new arcade game. The man said it was in the kitchen, way back in the back room. We followed the man into the room, when suddenly the lights went out. That's when the man took our lives, but only one child was able to escape from him. That child is you.
But I don't remember any of that. I don't even know a single trace.
That's because your subconscious suppressed the memory. Because it was too much for your psyche to handle at the time. The others lost the hope of
never being freed.
But I never did. I always believed that you would come back one day and save us, Mike. You're my best friend for a reason.
James?
It's been so long, Michael.
Oh, man.
So, you're not gonna stuff me?
No, we don't do that.
Then untie me, would ya? I'm not gonna run away.
Oh, of course. Sorry.
Oh man, this is cool. We finally see an animatronic talking to an actual
this
human.
This was just a precautionary measure,
or I guess James,
to keep you from running away before I had the chance to explain.
That makes sense.
I've missed you, James. Ever since I lost you and the others, I've been very scared to get new friends. Since I fear I would lose them too.
Man,
now we are back together. It's all right.
Who killed you? I mean, have you figured it out?
Is it Peter?
Yes. It was someone called David Parks.
Parks?
My name is David Parks.
He called me to inform me about my job.
What the hell?
Be very careful. He's dangerous. That's what I was going to talk about next. See, when the others left, and when I say the others, I mean those that possessed these things before us. When they left, we learned that the only way our souls could leave these things was, first, the murderer had to die, and second, these things had to be dismantled completely.
I think I get what you're saying. Would you like me to kill Parks and I dismantle you?
No, that won't work. We have to murder him. If you murder him, it's not going to do anything.
So we have to get him here, somehow.
That's why we need you. It also has to be during the nighttime, for obvious and unobvious reasons.
Yeah.
That's our cue. I will trust that you handle your part. If and when you do, we will handle ours too.
I will. Trust me.
Oh man. Interesting. So Mike actually has a much bigger backstory. So that's really cool. Because I mean, in the game, he kind of just there. Sorry, there's an ad, guys. Because he kind of just there in the original game. So I'm really glad that he actually have some backstory and actually related to this animatronic. And are they working together? Awesome, because I've been wondering to see
those
more,
things
you know.
Napped you, but they didn't stuff you in a suit?
Yes.
And then Freddy Fazbear himself talked to you and told you that he's an old friend of yours that David Parks murdered in the 80s, and now they possess those mascots up on the stage?
Yeah.
And now they need your help to get their revenge and to be able to move on?
Exactly.
Are you sure you weren't dreaming?
Yes. My mind has concealed the memories of what happened
that
day.
What do you decide to tell Henry anyway?
So I was able to cope with it when I was younger. James brought the details back into my mind. I remember everything now. It was Parks. There's no doubt about it.
So it wasn't Peter. Huh. I always thought he had an accomplice hiding somewhere in the shadows.
Peter?
The original guard and the former head manager before he went missing. He was Fred's business partner and he was up to some shady shit to keep this place in business.
You know,
including but not limited to murdering children to satisfy his crazy lusts. This is not the first time those robots are being haunted, you know. But I believe you. You haven't been here long enough to get crazy yet.
So, you'll help me free my friends?
I'm not sure how hard this will be, but if David indeed did all that, what goes around comes around, that's for sure. I'll help you, Mike. Those poor children deserve it. Never like to work here anyways.
Okay. So, they're actually gonna team up, which is pretty cool. I thought I was confused because why Mike decided to trust Henry, but I guess Henry also has this or listened to this story before, so obviously he knows what was up, I guess you could say that. Okay, so I think we're going to see his, Mike backstory, along with James and the other maybe. Yeah. And it's pretty interesting to see that, you know, the role.
I'm gonna get ya!
Oh, no you don't.
Oh, man!
Yes, I win!
Well played, Mike.
Do you have any more tokens?
Nah, I'm ball out. That was a ball-ass token.
That was a great match, though.
Yeah, definitely.
Hey, guys, check out what I just got. Sweet. It looks cute.
It does, doesn't it?
Gosh, now I want one.
That's easy. Come with me.
Wow. That's a lot of plushies.
Which one do you want, James?
Let's see. I think a Freddy one. But, I'm all out of tokens, though.
Let me buy one for you.
Wait, you would do that?
Of course, that's what friends are for. Besides, I've been a busy girl.
Man.
One Freddy plushie, please.
There you go.
Aw, thank you, Chloe.
Oh, Chloe. Okay.
Sure thing. You want one too, Mike?
No, thanks. I'm not really into plushies.
Alright, come. Let's go show Eric and Stanley.
But everyone knows me! Freddy Fazbear!
I could use some more pizza.
You can't live off pizza all the time.
Oh man, it's so cool to see the animatronic perform, you know.
Need to have carrots.
That you looks like some? An actual performance.
What were those again?
Plushies.
Oh yeah.
How's the show going, Eric?
It's the same thing it was last time. I feel like they just repeat the same lines over and over again. It's not funny anymore.
I think it's time for us to find a new place to hang out at.
But this is like the best place.
To be fair, Mike, I'd rather hang out here than at Candy's Burger and Fries.
Nothing beats the pizzas. Nothing.
Hey, Mike, would you go pick something for us? I trust you enough to bring the best ones.
Sure, why not?
Here you go. That should be enough.
Thanks. I'll be right back.
Man, what a bro. So we got Mike, James, Chloe, Eric, and Stanley, I think. I think this is David Park, I think. Oh man, the spring bonnie suit. Jesus, man.
For today's lesson, we will be continuing our training on proper suit handling techniques. When using an animatronic as a suit, please ensure that the animatronic parts are tightly compressed and fastened by the spring lock located around the inside of the suit. It may take a few moments. Position your head and torso between these parts in a manner where you can move and speak. Try not to nudge or press against any of the spring locks inside the suit. Do not touch the spring locks at any time. Do not breathe on the spring locks, as moisture may loosen them and cause them to break loose. In case that the spring locks come loose while you are wearing a suit, remember to smile. You are the face of Freddy Fazbear's pizza.
Oh, man. It's always a man inside of a suit, right? That lured the children.
What would you like?
Hey, guys?
Oh no.
Where did you go?
Oh no.
Tell me, are you enjoying your time at Freddy's?
Yeah, but I can't find my friends.
Oh, that's odd. Where did you see them last?
They were sitting right here.
Oh man, okay,
I saw your buddies. If you follow me, I can help you find them.
I don't know. Mom told me to never
follow- But I'm not a stranger. Your best part. You can always trust me.
I guess you're right.
Follow me.
Oh man. Well, this is not gonna end well, obviously.
Let us go!
We never did anything to you.
There is no need to beg. Nobody is coming. Just wait for your turn.
Oh man, what a sick bastard.
Wakey, wakey. Hope you slept well. You need a lot of strength for what's coming next.
Why are you doing this?
I'm so glad you ask.
Don't you dare hurt him, you son of a bitch!
Oh man.
You see, when I was just a young little boy, my parents and my family, they absolutely hated me. They would kick me. They would beat me. Day after day after day after day. That was no way to treat a boy like me. My dad told me it was for the best, that I somehow deserved it. And my brother told me, you cannot see why we do these things before you've done them yourself. And he was right. As I carved him up like a chicken and stripped him clean of meat, I realized he was right. I sat my whole family at the dinner table and said, thank you. You made me see. Now, it's time to make you see.
Man, that's fucked up.
You've been blind for long enough. Let me show you the path.
Please, no!
Oh, God. Fuck, man.
No, stop hurting my friends.
No. No, get away from me.
Oh.
Get off me. Come on. That's what you get.
My god, this freaking ad, man. Every single time. Sorry, guys. I'm just breaking the tension here. And Mike escaped. Man, that was finally we get some at least backstory for the villain, David Park, I'm assuming, because obviously he has an abusive family, and then he killed him, and then obviously like he's finally saw like, you know, his twisted mind and all that kind of stuff. Obviously messed up, really messed up, and it's just wow. This episode is really brutal. You know, episode 4 is really brutal to see how David just immediately killed the, you know, Mike's friend like that. And Chloe just got punched, but I'm pretty sure she's going to, David's going to kill her anyway, right? And Mike escaped, and I think we all know that in episode 3 already it was confirmed. So James is Freddy, and then I'm assuming Chloe is Chica because, well, it's a female, and then either Eric or Stanley is going to be Bonnie and Foxy, obviously. And I just really can't wait to see them teaming up to actually kill David Park, you know, along with Henry, obviously. So that's interesting. So we got two killers now. We got Peter, and then we got David. David actually has some sort of like backstory, so actually you know why he was doing this kind of stuff. I mean, it's not justifiable, obviously. It's really messed up. But for Peter, I don't think we actually see Peter's origin story. I feel like he's just there just to to kill people or something like that. Or maybe I missed something. I don't know, because I feel like if I remember the plot from the like previous episodes, I don't think I remember a single backstory for Peter. He's kind of just there to kill the kids, you know. And I guess it's confirmed that this took place not this one. This one is took place in 1984, but like episode 3 where Mike become the Night Guard on the Freddy Fazbear Pizza. It seems like that took place like 30 years later, I'm assuming, because Henry does mention Peter. So Peter was actually well known that day, and it seems like Fazbear Fred also exists at that time, and I think that was the time where Fred burned down the place. So that's pretty cool though, to see that. Okay, so now Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, and Foxy got possessed by this new spirit, like James, Chloe, Eric, and Stanley, obviously. And they're actually teaming up with the Night Guard, because it's kind of really funny, because I actually keep wondering that can we finally see a human teaming up with an animatronic, because we rarely see that, right? We kind of get the tease from, you know, ZC37 and then ABS-FM, but obviously this is not gonna work. At least for now, but who knows, maybe in their future episode we get to see humans and animatronic teaming up. I don't know, that would be kind of cool, at least in my opinion. But Hidden Lord 2 does just give me that, you know, we see Mike Smith teaming up with the animatronic, even though the animatronic is his friend, I know that, but still, they're animatronic at the end of the day, right? They become the animatronics, and then they're teaming up with Mike Smith, which is obviously now the Night Guard. And now my dream is fulfilled. You know, we actually see a human teaming up with an animatronic. That was really cool. I just really can't wait to see Mike's story to get resolved in the future, and finally get to see that, you know, his friend finally, you know, finally rest in peace, you know, for like forever, obviously. And it's just like, yeah, it's cool to see that the animatronic is, or I guess it's cool to see the rules that you need to kill the killer first, and then that's why you can move on. That explains why, you know, because in episode one, at least in the ending of episode one, Peter got killed, right, by, I guess by the spring Bonnie suit, and I think this is because of him laughing inside of the spring lock suit, obviously, kind of like purple guy, obviously, and I guess that's, you know, obviously that's why this previous spirits leave, and now it's also inhabited by a new spirits, and now we see them teaming up with humans, you know, that is cool, and I'm assuming that the puppet is gonna be the one who told James that that's how it works, you know, because it seems like the puppet is there when Fred burned down the Fazbear Fright along with Peter, like he's actually nodding to the puppet, obviously working together with the puppet, and obviously when the spirit is actually trying to get to Peter in the last episode for Hidden Lord 1, the puppet was also there, and it seems like he's commanding the spirits or something like that. So it seems like the puppet is gonna be like this supernatural entity and not just like an animatronic, you know, I'm assuming. But then again, who knows? Because he kind of appeared in the 1987 timeline, but I mean, who knows? I think at this point, he's just going to be a supernatural animatronic in some way. So that's very cool. And I hope that we get to see more of the puppet here, because it seems like he's going to help the mission. Maybe, who knows? Either way, guys, that was the Final Fantasy Hidden Lore episode 3 and 4. What do you guys, kind of let me know in the comment section below, what do you guys think about this 2 episode right here? Do you guys actually enjoy it, or do you guys think it could be better or something like that? You know, what do you guys think about the story so far? If you're actually new and you're actually watching this series together with me, well, you guys can let me know what you guys think about the series, and, you know, for now, I guess, because again, there is still more episode to come. And if you guys actually already watched the entire series, then again, I said this many times, don't spoil anything, please. I'm really grateful that none of you actually spoil anything for the past episode, so I'm really grateful for that, guys. But please, just keep doing that for pretty much after I caught up with the series, obviously. I mean, once I caught up with the series, there is no spoilers, obviously. So yeah, please, guys. And yeah, just let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. I'd like to hear them. And if you guys want to watch the original video, then I will leave a link in the description below. As always, make sure you guys check out Zapper770 channel. I will leave the channel's link also in the description below. And if you guys enjoyed this video, then please leave a like, comment, and, you know, subscribe to the channel and ring that notification bell and share the videos. And I just want to say thank you for everybody for subscribing to the channel and or just watching my videos, liking my videos, or commenting on one of my videos. Again, guys, thank you very much for that. I really appreciate that, guys. I hope that you guys can continue your support for the future, because again, I have future plan for the channel. It's not just gonna be Final Fantasy Freddy's the entire time. So again, please keep continuing your support, guys. And hopefully this channel can become big one day, you know. And I really hope you guys enjoyed this episode or this video, and I will see you guys in the next one then. Bye.